Hey guys, Jeremy Frains here. Top 10 most complimented fragrances in the amount of total compliments I have received. So number 10, although this is super sexy, Dolce & Gabbana The One, I do not get so many compliments for it as I would think. Because whenever I show this to a woman, they or she absolutely loves it. But oftentimes, for example, a compliment I received just when somebody came close to me, because it's very much in your intimate area. So it's not an attention grabber, but if people can smell it, you get compliments. Number 9, also, I mean, the competition is very hardcore. Acqua di Gio Profumo, a superstar. Actually, before I released my fragrances, I said this is the best men's fragrance on earth, Acqua di Gio Profumo. But against the other ones, in total, I have not received as many compliments, but definitely this one is a great compliment getter too. Now, in-house competition, Armani Coat Absolue, huge compliment getter, much sweeter. I've noticed that actually you either get the compliments for very sweet attention grabbing, ooh, what was that sexy sweet smell? Or you get the compliments for the fresh and clean ones. This is definitely the sweet and sexy category. This is Armani Coat Absolu. Very sexy fragrance. Oh, and this one is a powerful one. This is called Tobacco Oud by Tom Ford. And this, guys and girls, is also a negative compliment getter, meaning it also gives me negative feedback. And more than any other fragrance I've ever worn, but also it is balanced out by the amount of compliments I've received for it. Actually, let me do it today. Let's see if I'm an animal today. Oh man, this is a beast. Okay, next one is Guerlain L'Homme Idéal Eau de Parfum. And there are the other versions. I think they are the same because I tried the Extreme, the Intense, blah, blah. They all smell pretty much just like this. I don't know why this is discontinued. I think possibly the bottle looks uncool or something. Something is wrong with the bottle, or I don't know. But this one got me huge amount of compliments. It's an unusual compliment getter. It's a cherry vanilla fragrance. How many men's fragrances are there with a cherry note? Not many. This one is good compliment getter. The total amount of compliments I received for Chanel Allure Homme Sport Eau Extreme, I think, as far as I remember, back in the days, was also pretty good. It's a bit of a waste of a money if you're just looking for a fresh and clean fragrance, because it actually has similar, which means not crazy good performance, like some of these $20 fresh and clean fragrances. But it's a Chanel and it's based on mainly natural notes like mint, pepper, and sweet tonka bean. Great compliment getter. Ah, I love it. But yeah, it's not a must have. But again, huge compliment getter. Gives you a nice fresh aura. Oh, now it's getting heavy. Now these ones are complete different league. Completely different league. The next four ones. Ultra Male by Jean Paul Gaultier, megastar. And by the way, I got my own fragrance which is similar to that one, not a clone, we don't do that, but similar, but even better. And number 3, Dior Sauvage Eau de Toilette. Get the Eau de Toilette, it's the best one, although I personally love the Eau de Parfum the most, not the Eau de Toilette and not the Parfum and not the Eau de Cool Spray. But price value wise and freshness balanced with the spices in it, I think for most people is this the best. But I personally love the Eau de Parfum more. It's more powerful. But this one, mega star, such a huge compliment getter still. And yeah, just about 2 days ago, I have worn not this, but a clone of this. And I got 2 compliments in about 10 minutes. So this is the number 2 most complimented fragrance by the amount of compliments in total I have received. Creed Aventus. And yeah, here and there from my from my 100% of wearings, these type of stuff, I have worn this about 10% and this 90%. This did give me some compliments also when I wore it, but clearly this is the original superstar, Creed Aventus. But I don't know if I will still have this video up, Aventus versus Aventus. In any case, I noticed some badge variations. So this is already the new one. It's a new cap and all that stuff. I feel like the older the badge is, the better and more powerful this DNA is. So take it with a grain of salt. And the number one most complimented fragrance by the amount of total compliments I've received is La Nuit de L'Homme. But watch out, don't buy it blindly. Why? Because it's also reformulated. Man, this sucks. It doesn't perform so good like it used to. Man, sick, sick. And I got two honorable mentions right here. If you want to spend some money, these also got me good compliments. Amouage Reflection Man, huge. And Leighton Exclusive, also huge compliment getter. And when it comes to my brand, the biggest compliment getter is this one. Unisex is almost annoyingly sexy, but it's just annoyingly, what is this smell, man? I love this smell. It's just, this is the compliment DNA. Never in my life I have had, in my research of creating a fragrance, so much feedback from the people I gave this fragrance to or any other fragrance. The text messages, they said, well, my girlfriend loves it, and here, Gunn loves it. I mean, this is the wife of that guy, for example, in New York. And hey, I first didn't like the top note, but I like it now more. And just the feedback to this was incredible. Get unisex if you want to buy my brand, especially go with the bundle section and at the beginner bundle for men. Guys, I love you. Have a great day. Thank you, God, for guiding me how you want to guide me. Peace, guys.